guiding, aiding the believer in the things of God. So he shares with us from John 14 and 16 as Christ says, I'm going to leave you the comfort, the paraclete, the supreme biblical comfort. Again, his job is to come alongside and help us, aid us, to guide us. Not only in our time of need, but he helps us if we allow him to, each and every day of our lives. Y'all with me so far? So we have the notion. Christ desires that we be comforted, but also the responsibility that we comfort one another. So how does this come to pass? How does this work? Go with me to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Let's talk about this a little bit tonight. Second Corinthians chapter 1, we'll start at verse number 3. Second Corinthians chapter 1, starting at verse number 3. Y'all have it? Alright. Here Paul writes to the church at Corinth. He says, blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all what? God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble, by the comfort wherewith we also are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings, which we also suffer, or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as ye are partakers of the sufferings, so shall ye be also of the consolation. Y'all see that? Now do an exercise for me real fast. Between verse 3 and verse 7. How many times do you see the word comfort? Somebody? See the word comfort or comforted? See the word comfort or comforted? I think if you read through verse 3 through 7, you ought to see it about 9 or 10 times. Short of that, then you're shortchanging yourself. The word comfort or comforted, you see about 9 or 10 times. Right? Now let me ask you this, go through the same text, pericope of scripture. Tell me how many times you see the word afflicted or suffered. How many times do you see the word afflicted or suffering? Verses 3 through 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 through 7. How many times do you see the word afflicted or suffering? You can use trouble too. In trouble, afflicted, suffering. How many times do you see it? I think trouble is only one.
Twice.
But you see afflicted and suffering. How many times do you see those words?
I see suffering.
So here we go. Let me read this for you all again. When we get to one of these words, we will stop. I want you to highlight it or underline it. Verse 3. Blessed be the God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all what? How many times is that come?
One.
That's one. Who does what? Y'all see that? That's two, right?
Yes.
Who comforted us in all of our tribulation or trouble. That we may be able to do what?
Comfort.
Is that three?
Yes.
Them which are in any what?
Trouble.
Okay. By the what?
Comfort.
How many comforts we got so far?
Four.
How many troubles or afflicted or sufferings do we have so far?
Three.
Okay. Somebody said three. What do you think? We got two. Where will it stop it? By the comfort? Verse 5. For as the what?
Suffering.
There go three, right?
Yes.
Of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounded by Christ. And whether we be what?
Distressed.
Or afflicted. Either one, distressed or afflicted. King James Version says afflicted. So there goes four. Mm-hmm. It is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same what? Sufferings. That's five. Which we also do what? Suffer. That's six. Or whether we be, here's another, comforted. How many comforted do we have?
Five.
Yeah, I got
one. One, two, three, four. Yep, I'm at six. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as you are partakers of the sufferings, we had seven, so shall ye also of the consolation. Y'all with me? So, Pastor, why did you help us to do that exercise? Because I need you to understand that you can't just experience the comfort of Christ. There's also the afflictions and the sufferings that come with it. Right there, as Paul is talking to the believers, he needs us to understand that we share in the sufferings of Christ. Not only is he the God of all comfort, but if you are a believer in Jesus Christ, you also need to understand that at times in this journey, we will also suffer and be afflicted. So catch this. Coming to Christ does not cancel your crisis. The misconception that we have a lot of times in the churches, we think now that we're saved, nothing bad happens to us. Now that we've accepted Christ, we don't have trouble because now I have Jesus. No, the devil is a liar. Christ tells us that we were suffering, catch this, for his sake. hear the comforting part about the text is that as much as we see afflicted and suffering, guess what we also see? It's right there in the text. Comfort. So the exercise you ought to do in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 through 7, is I don't care if you highlight the one or circle the other, but you ought to be able to go through there and see that even though I see afflicted and suffering, I also see that there's comfort right there in the midst. But what I cannot do in my life as a believer is think that I'm just always going to be comforted but never be afflicted and never have to suffer. And see, if we can understand that, if we can grasp that as a part of our lives, it becomes easier when we understand that our responsibility of also comforting each other. Because we also understand we all get afflicted. We all suffer.